I believe everyone has the potential to excel, given the right support and guidance. I have a number of people on my team who don't come from traditional tech backgrounds. As someone who's interviewed candidates here in the last 10 years, I've been able to look beyond their resume and focus on their drive to learn. The Global Marketing Response Center team consists of members from 27 countries, fluent in more than 30 languages. I think it is this diversity that allows us to best serve all our different customers. My team's focus is on supporting customers who are in their early stages of adopting our cloud technology. We then help them move forward in their digital transformation. My favorite part of the job is being able to provide my team with opportunities to stretch in their careers and push the boundaries on what they thought was possible. Even when members of my team move on to different roles at AWS, I love watching them grow. My name is Livian, and I am a builder.
Hello, everyone. My name is Livian, and I lead the global MRC team here in AWS. MRC stands for Marketing Response Center. My team's mission is to provide personalized one-to-one engagement for our early-stage customers to help them quickly and easily adopt our cloud technology. I have been involved in many AWS summits across Asia and globally, but the ASEAN Summit will always have a special place in my heart, as I was one of the first few members who set up the APAC Business Operations office here in Singapore back in 2010. I still vividly remember our first Singapore summit that took place on 17 July 2013, just 2 days before my third anniversary. Anniversary is a word we use when we celebrate our work anniversaries here in Amazon. I'm very, very happy to have just celebrated my 10-year anniversary last year, but I'm still learning and growing along with the team. So Shavita, thanks so much for being my co-presenter today.
Pleasure.
Can you also introduce yourself to the audience?
Sure, absolutely. Thank you, Livian. And hi, all. My name is Shafida. I lead the Enterprise Executive Team in ASEAN. Mm-hmm. The team is also known as ESE. Our team consists of builders who are passionate about helping enterprise customers transform and innovate using cloud technology. I'm super excited to be here as part of the AWS Summit, and particularly in a diverse region as ASEAN. Inclusion, diversity, and equity, they're really close to my heart, as I see this firsthand in my own team, where I have almost every builder from a different nationality, covering each key ASEAN country. They come with different educational backgrounds, and we have a great balance of gender diversity too. And I see how this helps the team on a day-to-day basis, leveraging the different strengths and point of views from one another, and help them better connect with our customers. Now, I would say, Livian, you are such a cultural champ and inclusion ambassador here at AWS, and the most familiar face to our customers, especially of late. I've watched the AWS Builder series, and I saw that your story was published online in March in conjunction with the occasion of International Women's Day. Now, can you tell us a little bit more of the behind the scenes? Why was it important for you to tell your story as a veteran here?
Well, I'm so glad you watched the video. Well, I'm so humbled, honored, and excited to be featured in this Global AWS Builder Series stories. The whole production was so fun. We spent the entire day filming while adhering to local filming regulations, you know, during these unusual times. There were so many candid and memorable moments. And looking back, that's really how my team operates every day. We are a very close-knit team, always very open and chatty. So during the filming, the producer asked me for a personal favorite item. So without any hesitation, I went to my home office and took out this, a mother hen clay figurine, which was personally made by my children as a gift for me on Mother's Day many, many years ago. Mm-hmm. And if you watch my video, you will see it in the video during my story that I that was featured. What's so cool about it is that there was this word spelled as M-O-M, mom, handwritten on it. And my youngest daughter always tells me that, you know, whenever I'm, you know, feeling down or, you know, need a happy boost, I just need to turn it upside down and then I will see the word wow. And I really, really was touched by it. You know, my family always tells me that I'm a mother, not just to them, but also they see me acting as a mother figure to my MRC family. And the growing number of talent that I hired throughout the AWS organization in the last 10 years. Mm-hmm. I believe everyone has the potential to excel, mm-hmm. given the right support and guidance. My team consists of 27 nationalities and comes from diverse backgrounds, and many of them do not necessarily come from technical background either. Mm-hmm. So we need this diversity to best serve our different customers all around the world. This is because the work that we do requires diverse opinions and perspectives, because our customers are equally diverse, not just in this region, but all around the world. This is why I'm happy to share my story about my team and how we develop the best talent here in AWS. Because we need the best team to support the best personalized support and take care of all our customers' very different needs, depending on where they are on their cloud journey and the verticals they are in. Okay. So I'm sure your current ASEAN role and previously in your APAC role, you have, you know, witnessed many customers based in Asia. Would you like to tell us more about some of these customers?
Yeah, absolutely, Livian. It's always great to see companies that use AWS Cloud to scale, like Taskus in the Philippines. Now, this is a business process outsourcing provider that offers back office support and customer experience consulting. Mm-hmm. And by the way, BPO is one where we have a lot of women in the workforce.
Wow, that's amazing.
Yeah, absolutely. And during these unusual times, Taskus agents had to work remotely instead of their centralized BPO offices. By using AWS services like Amazon EC2, Amazon RDS, and Amazon Redshift, Taskus was able to deploy a secure and scalable solution to grant its agents remote access to work applications. AWS enabled thousands of Taskus agents to work from home and will offer free credits to 1,000 more agents in Manila and 3,500 agents in the US.
Wow, that's amazing. I didn't know that.
Absolutely, to help them with short-term app deployment. We have another example with a leading insurer in Singapore. Now, following the announcement of tightening COVID-19 measures, this insurance company had to move its centralized contact center virtually to enable its employees to service their most critical hotlines remotely. Using Amazon Connect, they set up a virtual contact center to deal with the increased volume of pandemic-related customer inquiries. The Amazon Connect-based contact center was built within a day.
Wow.
And it came with a fully functional queue ready to service customer requests. Mm-hmm. Right. The Connect-based contact center supported 40 to 60 agents, serviced 13 hotlines, and was equipped to handle 200 concurrent calls. So it's really great to see how companies adapt to changing trends and use cloud as an enabler here. We also have Halodoc in Indonesia that offers medical teleconsultations, pharmacy delivery, and at-home lab services across Indonesia. During COVID-19, Halodoc collaborated with more than 20 hospitals in Greater Jakarta and Karawang, West Java, allowing users to book COVID-19 testing appointments through its mobile app. By running on AWS services like Amazon EC2 reserved instances, Amazon RDS, Amazon S3, Amazon CloudFront, Amazon Route 53, and AWS Lambda, Halodoc reduced IT costs by 20 to 30%. With the IT costs saved, Halodoc's DevOps team reallocated their resources and launched new app features that were 30% faster than the previous versions, improving the patient-physician mobile call response times. Now, these are just some of the customer anecdotes that I came across. So, Livian, with the large team that you have in MRC, I'm really keen to understand the kind of questions that you're hearing from customers and the trends across.
Yeah. So, as we communicate with customers who are considering cloud for the first time or at their early stage of cloud adoption, our customers show very high interest in learning, especially very curious about AWS services, our other customer success stories, getting AWS certifications, and learning more about our upcoming marketing events and trainings. Therefore, together with our partners, we have been helping our customers with localized content and resources to help to serve their needs. Since the pandemic, we also see a lot of customers asking us to help them with cost optimization as they adopt the cloud. We also see different trends happening across ASEAN. For example, here in Singapore, we experience cloud first becoming more normalized for SMB and startup customers, as many customers see AWS having the most matured cloud technology offering, offering the broadest and the deepest set of cloud services. Therefore, they often come to AWS first when they have any IT needs. In Malaysia, cloud adoption is steadily increasing, and we also see customers interested in advanced services such as Internet of Things and artificial intelligence and machine learning, which are very attractive, especially for customers in the industrial space. And over in Vietnam, cloud adoption is accelerating very quickly, with many customers either looking to migrate their traditional data centers or looking for a flexible cloud environment for their new products development and testing. And finally, in Indonesia, as you know, customers are eagerly waiting for the AWS region launch in the country.
Oh, I can imagine.
Especially in customers in the FSI space or customers who want to migrate on-premise workload to the AWS cloud. Meanwhile, we do have many more of such customers across different verticals and industries, and also from the public sector side, who are also experiencing the new normal empowered by cloud technology. Now let's go over to Malaysia and hear from the colleague there. Hi Adila, so good to have you here with us virtually.
Thank you, Livian and Shafida. I've always enjoyed our discussion even though it will remain virtual for now. Hi everyone, apa khabar semua? Thank you to all of you joining us from all over Asia. My name is Adila and I'm the Partner Development Manager for Public Sector in AWS. I am responsible to develop the partner community which supports our public sector customer. The public sector team works closely with government, education institutions, and non-profit organizations. It has been such an exciting journey for me to drive the adoption of AWS Cloud in Malaysia. The topic of inclusion and diversity is important to me because the combination of experiences, perspectives, and cultural background make us who we are and will lead to serve our ASEAN customers better. We have such a diverse AWS team here in Malaysia. Hey, Livian, such an awesome video you have there. And so good that you have hired and developed talent in 27 countries and counting. I have to mention too that here in AWS Malaysia team, we have also published a video featuring our diverse and passionate Malaysia team. They make work so much fun, and there's nothing that we cannot do together with a dream team such as this. What binds us all is, of course, customer obsession. Within the public sector space, a lot has been going in the past year. First, in terms of upskilling and reskilling, public sector customers are looking into cloud to enhance digital services for all citizens. Inclusion and diversity is also a big focus for many companies in Malaysia, and this goes beyond public sector. Petronas, for example, is one of our customers in Malaysia, and they are very much known for their strong emphasis in welcoming young talent from all backgrounds, tech and non-tech, to come forward and learn about their industry, offering them learning and also career opportunities. Asia Pacific University of Technology and Innovation, APU, and University Technology Mara, UITM, both on AWS Educate program in Malaysia. Through AWS Educate, students and educators have access to content and programs developed to skill up for cloud careers. Both APU and UITM have been encouraging students to learn more and embrace technology. Everyone can be a builder, and one doesn't need to have actual technical skills to be able to contribute to big ideas. Hey, do you know I actually graduated with a degree in commerce and not engineering or computer science? Many of us here in Malaysia team as well. Actually, what you studied and what you are applying in your role as a builder here doesn't matter. We still love to hear your voice and your perspective. I'm curious, Livian and Shafida, what did you both study back in school?
Well, Adela, this is really a fun topic. I think many people know me as a marketer, but not many people know that I studied information systems and computer science back in university, so that's very geeky. So after graduation, I took on a role as a software programmer in the insurance industry for 2 years. If some of you may remember, it's really fixing the Y2K bug on the AS400 mainframe machines. That's really fun. Yeah. And then I did my MBA with a focus in marketing. And later on, I switched my career to marketing in high-tech industry. And I have not looked back since. I love what I'm doing today and for so many years now. Well, in looking back, the IT landscape has also changed very rapidly thanks to cloud technology. In my opinion, what we have studied in the past doesn't really matter anymore. What matters, however, is that no matter or regardless what background you come from, is that you always have the passion about learning and always curious about things around you. For example, being interested in STEM, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, and the powerful developments that can come along with it when one embraces technology. So what about you, Shabida?
Yeah, absolutely. I completely agree with you, Livian. I did graduate with an engineering degree as well, but I did my postgrad in marketing and finance, and which led me to my career path thereafter. One of my favorite leadership principles here in Amazon is learn and be curious. And I think anyone...
That's my favorite one too.
I think anyone with the right attitude to learn is more likely to really like what they do in tech fields, right? Rather than the actual academic background. So for example, we have Devika, who joined AWS in the recruiting team initially. And she did that for a couple of years. However, she saw that her passion was actually in cloud technology and helping customers transform. So despite her non-technical background, she invested time to learn and she became AWS Solution Architect certified. She then made a successful transition to the AWS Professional Services team, helping customers in their cloud adoption journey. We also have Kathy in our ESC team, who comes from a social science and economics background. And within 4 months of joining, she completed her AWS Solution Architect exam, and as well as her speaker certification course internally. And she used this to help guide her customers better across business and technical challenges. Now, these are just two of the many individuals that I know who've been really building in creative ways. So it's really great cases all around of how colleagues and women in particular that I know who are constantly learning topics that they are passionate about to help customers. So Adila, you must know more colleagues in the region. And anyone else you think, you know, with an interesting background that you'd like to share?
Definitely. I have so many names to contribute. I will need more time. Firstly, I definitely need to talk about our well-respected Tan Lee Chew, who is our Managing Director for ASEAN Public Sector Business. Lee Chew actually studied philosophy back in uni, and she is so involved in technology discussions all across Southeast Asia. Did you know, too, that many of our builders come from diploma, polytechnic, technical institute background, and they are all doing very well, working so closely with our customers and partners in Malaysia and around the region?
Well, Adela, I completely agree with you. Cloud computing, well, in fact, actually hasn't been around for that long, as AWS was established back in, well, 2006, and we've got at least 6 to 7 years of a head start ahead of the industry. It's really important for both our customers and partners, as well as many organizations, to come together to build the future of cloud by opening up the community to welcome more people from all backgrounds to build and innovate together. In my 10 years of interviewing, well, in AWS, I certainly look beyond the resume and look at the willingness to, well, unlearn and relearn. And I also tend to observe who is always unhappy about customer experiences and wanting to invent, iterate, and reinvent again to ensure the best customer experience can be achieved.
Yeah. I personally endorse our Amazon founder, mm-hmm. Jeff Bezos' line that our customers are always wonderfully and beautifully dissatisfied, mm-hmm. right? And he also published a note just this year reminding all of us to let curiosity be our compass, mm-hmm. right? And see that as the guiding light for one to keep inventing and mm-hmm. with a strong bias for action. This note and this advice is actually so relevant and so true. Mm-hmm. Something for us to tell not just our customers, but actually our children too.
Absolutely.
Now, if you have one advice to the individuals and to the organizations tuning in now mm-hmm. on inclusion and diversity and how leaders can make a change mm-hmm. And contribute to a more inclusive workplace, Livian, what would your advice be?
Well, as a woman, mother, and professional, I never expected to be doing the work I'm doing today. It's been a great journey where my curiosity and eagerness to learn has been the main driving factor for me. Mm. Working for probably the most disruptive company in the world has presented many great challenges and opportunities from which I have been thriving and benefited from. Mm. So my advice to any woman out there who is interested in technology is to be curious about everything around you, ready to embrace the constant change we experience daily. Don't view them as stumbling blocks. Instead, you can turn them into an advantage and a new learning for you.
Absolutely. Well said, Livian, and I completely agree with you. I'm sure Adila too. So on behalf of everyone here in AWS, we'd like to thank all our customers and partners for joining the three of us for this important and much needed discussion on inclusion and diversity. We all have an important role to play to make sure technology is inclusive, accessible, and flexible to all. Let's continue to lead and uplift one another as we continue to innovate together. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.